torturing and raping the animals.
Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new, my name is Bobby. Guys, today we're gonna dive deep into the vegan mental illness with the video called The Best Vegan Fried Egg I've Ever Made by The Burger Dude. Let's have a look.
Today we are making a vegan fried egg. Yes, wow. You heard that right. This was super dang good and a lot easier to put together than I had anticipated. We'll be using a process called reverse spherification to make our yolks, which is super fun. You'll feel like a food scientist. Mm. Plus, for you folks who hate runny yolks, we've also got a technique to make over medium eggs. Mm. So let's get it going.
Wow.
For the egg white.
In a world where your forefathers fought for your comfort, you can simply walk into any supermarket and pick an egg. But you won't.
There are a few ingredients, starting with a quarter cup of some vegan yogurt. Make sure
cashews are supremely toxic, and the poor workers that have to pick them get severe burns on their hands. You could say that is human exploitation and cruelty to humans, but hey, it is vegan.
Vegan yogurt. Make sure you get unsweetened and plain. I really like this stuff by Forager. And next is 2 tablespoons of glutinous rice flour, which is different from regular rice flour, and will give our egg whites a denser texture.
That defies the whole purpose of egg whites. This is so hilarious to me. I come from a bodybuilding background. When vegans tell me there is a dairy alternative, there is an egg alternative, there's a meat alternative, I am interested in the macros and the micros. So egg whites just deliver protein. No carbohydrates, no fats. But you already failed providing that because you use cashew yogurt, which has a bunch of fat and carbs, and now you use rice flour, which is pure sugar. Egg whites have zero sugar and zero fat. That's the whole point.
Next is 2 tablespoons of aquafaba, which, if you don't know, is a weird goo from a can of chickpeas.
Wow.
It's a common replacement for egg whites, so I figured why not use it? Another important ingredient is this black salt, which will give the eggs the unique eggy flavor that we all
super
like.
Super easy, though.
I found that the flavor burns off if you apply this stuff before cooking, so I prefer to sprinkle some on after cooking the egg.
It's not an egg. Don't call it an egg.
Time to put together the yolk, and we're going to get into some science right now, and this idea is not mine. In fact, I saw this on Sauce Stash's channel last year, and I've been meaning to try it for a while.
That guy is the king of meat cravings.
And I've been meaning to try it for a while. Wow. I'll leave a link to his video in the description. And my buddy Jonathan over at Ticho's Table also has a good vegan egg recipe, so I'll leave that in there as well.
Man.
But for this, what we need to do is make an alginate bath with some sodium alginate. And this is what's going to form that layer around our yolk that's going to keep it together. So we're going to get 700 milliliters of distilled water, add that to a blender along with 5 teaspoons of the sodium alginate. And now I know these might sound like
scary chemicals,
but they are totally fine. Just Google it if you're that worried. Anyways, we're going to add
if you're that worried, just Google it. That will tell you.
1 teaspoon of the sodium alginate at a time to the blender. And then we're going to get a decent sized piece of Tupperware and pour that mixture in. We're going to cover it and let it hang out in the fridge overnight so that the air bubbles we just created will dissipate. And the next morning, our sodium alginate bath should be a lot less cloudy, and this is the consistency we've got. It's kind of
that looks like the glue that we used in school when we would craft certain little things. In Germany, we call it Kleister.
Like ectoplasm. And now for our yolk mixture, we'll need 1/2 can of pumpkin puree, 1/4 cup of vegan yogurt. I'm using the same stuff as I did in the whites.
Wow.
And of course, transfer to a larger bowl because you're a ding-dong. No, it's really because I decided I wanted to make a double batch, but I'm...
An egg is nature's multivitamin, aside from liver, of course, but you have so many fat-soluble vitamins in the yolk, vitamin A, vitamin D, etc. You have none of that in pumpkin. Yet again, an egg has zero carbohydrates. This is just sugar. This is what you do. You only consume carbs. I said it a billion times before. You have no egg replacement here because it doesn't deliver the fat-soluble vitamins and the proteins.
I'm giving you directions to make enough for 12 eggs.
It looks like an egg.
Next, we'll do 1 teaspoon of tapioca starch.
Wow.
Followed by 2 tablespoons of nutritional yeast. 1/2 tablespoon of mushroom seasoning, and then 1 tablespoon of aquafaba. And next, we'll whisk that together and drizzle in about 2 tablespoons of olive oil. And always taste and adjust for seasoning, or make it thinner or thicker by adding more liquid or starch. I ended up adding in some garlic and onion powder, which added a lot of good flavor. Okay, and last
good
but not
flavor.
Least,
do you understand that if you cook an egg, it already has flavor? You doesn't need to add anything. If you want, you can sprinkle on some salt. That's it.
Least another important ingredient, the calcium lactate, which we'll do 1/2 tablespoon of. This is what's going to react with the sodium alginate to form that membrane around our yolk. And for all these,
he already has 20 ingredients in this.
Super easy, you guys.
Less common ingredients, I'll leave links in the description for them as well. And now it's time for some fun. We're going to make our egg yolks. So I'm using a small scooper here. It's about 50% bigger than a tablespoon.
Oh, man.
And I'll just drop that yolk mixture into our sodium alginate bath. And then using a small spatula and another spoon, we kind of just want to move the alginate around.
I really can't
the yolk,
believe what I'm watching.
It'll sink down and form a little sphere. Let that hang out for about 30 seconds or so. And then we'll get a slotted spoon and we'll scoop it out of that alginate. Let it drip off for a bit and then wipe it with a paper towel. And then we're just going to let it chill out in some cool water. And I know this might seem like a lot of work and weird ingredients.
No!
What's cool is this alginate bath will be good for at least a week. So you can whip up a bunch of egg yolk and white mixture, have the alginate in the fridge, and then make a couple eggs every morning for a week. It's actually super convenient once you get...
Yeah, why not just get regular eggs? Man, I've been an ex-vegan for roughly 3 years now. Prior to that, I was vegan for 4 years. Looking at this now, finally recovered, rejuvenated after veganism, I can see the mental illness. It is so blatantly obvious what you try to do here. You want an egg because an egg is nutritious. Your body signalizes what it wants. Very, very simple. I need nutrition. That is what your body tells you. This is where you replicate those cruel animal products. Don't you get it? You are a human being.
Wake up!
You need animal nutrition in order to be healthy. You hate yourself. You hate your body. This is why you give it the fake stuff.
Everything put together.
That's it.
Speaking of which, let's fry up an egg. So we're going to get a
non-stick
pan over medium heat and add a bit of oil, or if you like, vegan butter. And then once that oil...
As if those two things were different. Hey, just take some oil or vegan butter. It's the same. It's both vegetable oil.
Oil is nice and hot. We'll pour in a bit of our white mixture. And I like to shake it around to help spread it a bit. This will help us get those crispy edges, if that's your thing. And then next, we'll plop down our yolk. And now all we got to do is fry this until it's done to our liking. And like I said,
you're
going to
be so disappointed, man. I'm not a huge egg fan myself, but back in the day when I was in Vietnam with my girlfriend, she loved eggs. She was a vegan because of me, was craving eggs on a daily basis. And then we went to a vegan restaurant that actually offered vegan eggs. Yay! The egg yolk was made out of carrots, I believe. And guess what? It didn't hit the spot. She tried to enjoy it, but ultimately she didn't get the effect that she was looking for. Just try it out, man. Go to a farm, buy a bunch of eggs, do an experiment. Just eat a bunch of eggs for a week or two and see how you will feel. There is so much nutrition in a simple egg that you can't find on a whole food plant-based diet. Stop torturing yourself.
If you are a fan of super crispy edges, get yourself a cast iron, get it ripping hot with some oil, and then
ripping hot and destroy everything that is left in that goo.
Fry your egg in that. I mean, listen to this thing. And for seasoning, I like to do some black pepper, a little salt, and then dust on some of that black salt for that eggy flavor, and maybe some of my favorite hot sauce in this kind of situation, some Valentina.
What else, man?
And there you go, a vegan fried egg. And is this going to fool a non-vegan? No, I doubt it. But if you are a fan of fried eggs, this definitely hits all the notes. The contrast of the crispy edges, the soft yolk, and the black salt infusing it with some eggy flavor is just amazing, if you ask
me. Just pathetic.
And of course, this
thing
is good on its own, but it's even better on some avocado toast. I mean, it's been years since I've had something like this, but like I said, it really does hit all those eggy notes. It's really just totally unbelievable. Now, of course, if you don't like runny yolk,
it is totally unbelievable.
Fancied a fried egg sandwich? Well, the process is even easier. Instead of making a yolk with the sodium alginate, we just need to take our yolk mixture, add a little tapioca starch to thicken it up, and then we'll fry it like we did before. Pour in some of the white, and then in the middle, just spoon in the thickened yolk mixture. Simply cook that until the bottom is nice and browned. Wow. Give her a flip. Add some vegan cheese if you please, and then cook until the other side is browned. Slap that between two pieces of toast, and by golly, you got yourself a vegan fried egg sandwich. And this was also
just
super
fake good. Food, man. Absolutely disgusting, bro.
Good, but I bet it'd be even better with some vegan bacon, lettuce, and tomato for the full sandwich experience. Or you could totally
look at this. Look how sick you are, man. You're so depraved. You're so far gone. And this is not an insult, really. I don't even see you. I have no idea how you look like. This is not against you. This is against your actions. Look what you try to replicate. It is meat, it is cheese, it is eggs. All the foods that have the nutrition that you need, that you crave, that you want, but you are denying it. Why do you do it to yourself? Because vegans hate themselves. I said it before, if you really find animal foods reprehensible, you find the act of killing,
torturing and raping the animals
so evil, then you wouldn't replicate those things. Now we have the metaverse, virtual reality. Should we cater to pedophiles? Should we create child porn? Hey, it's not real, it's just in the metaverse. Probably we will, because we are so sick as a society. It's okay, it's not the real thing. But we're gonna cater to those urges, those sick, sick urges of those people. This is your equivalent. You find this sick. You hate the animal torture, the abuse. So why do you replicate it on a daily basis, you sicko?
Put a fried egg on a vegan burger, as I feel like I'm mandated to by vegan law. And there you go. This was so freaking good. And I didn't even put any condiments or sauces on it. Next time, I gotta add some hash browns and chipotle ketchup or something like that.
Look at this. You're squeezing it. You try to create food porn because you want the runny egg yolk, man. But you want to sit in the cholesterol.
I really do hope you all give this a try. I think you'll be super stoked on it. Or you can totally make some of my other vegan breakfast sandwiches with it too. I'll leave some links right here.
All right, guys. And this is it. Your daily dose of vegan mental illness here on Bobby's Perspective. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, guys, leave it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, guys, please do so. And if you want to support this channel, all the links are in the description box below. Thank you so much for your support, guys. As always, may God bless you all. Much love and peace.